Aujourd'hui, en cette deuxième journée nationale de commémoration des victimes de catastrophes aériennes, on est réunis pour se souvenir des personnes qu'on a perdues suite à ces tragédies. On se souvient des passagers du vol 1363 d'Air Ontario, du vol 302 d'Ethiopian Airlines, du vol 182 d'Air India et du vol 752 de la Ukraine International Airlines. 3 years ago, Toronto-bound flight PS752 was shot down by Iranian missiles. With it, 176 souls were lost. People you loved, people you grieve for every day. On Friday, I spoke with some families of some surviving families. Beheshte lost her daughter, Bahare Karami, who was moving to Canada because of the challenges she faced as a woman in Iran. Merzad, my friend, a single father, lost his only son, Arad. He was 17 years old. Ali Dodd lost his brother, Ardalan, his nephew, Kamyar, and his sister-in-law, Niloufar. Ali Dodd joined our call on Friday from where he lives in Australia, where it was 3 in the morning. It was a reminder that the downing of PS752 is not just a Canadian tragedy, although we have mourned it across this country as a Canadian tragedy. The people around the world, yes, of course, in Iran, but also in countries far and wide, where this extraordinary community has not just set down roots, but contributed to the societies and the communities in which they contribute. People around the world feel this loss every single day. For victims' family members who want to be together in Canada, we have opened a pathway to permanent residency that will reunite grieving relatives so you can support each other. This tragedy happened because of the Iranian regime's heinous disregard for human life. Your grief has been compounded by their refusal to be held accountable. Nothing will ever bring your loved ones back. But when you lose someone so senselessly, finding justice is a part of mourning. We need closure in order to heal. And Iran's refusal to be held accountable is denying you that. Well said. 2 weeks ago, one of the things that Canadians saw through this tragedy, and people around the world have discovered through the extraordinary diaspora communities in their countries, in their cities, in their towns, is that the Islamic Republic is not representative and is not indicative of the extraordinary, wonderful, warm, brilliant people of Iran, who deserve so much better. Two weeks ago, we initiated a process to bring the Islamic Republic of Iran into binding arbitration to ensure accountability and justice. We worked alongside the UK, Sweden, and of course, Ukraine, who are dealing with the horrific invasion by Russia, supported and aided by the Islamic Republic of Iran. But Ukraine and President Volodymyr Zelensky ensured that the measures were taken so that we could move forward in time for the third anniversary. And I want to thank the Ukrainian government and Ukrainian people for standing, even as they grieve through their losses, standing with the people of Iran. And of course, if the Iranian regime does not comply within 6 months with this binding arbitration, we will take the next steps and move to the International Court of Justice, where there will be accountability. On va continuer d'être là pour vous soutenir. Et on va continuer d'être là pour demander des comptes au régime iranien. Just a few minutes ago, I visited the art exhibit that you organized. It laid out the many crimes of the Iranian regime and its human rights abuses. The killing of Mahsa Amini last year struck a deep chord not only in Iran, but in a way that has resonated and continues to resonate around the world. Canada and all Canadians stand with the women of Iran, schoolgirls to grandmothers, and all the people of Iran who are demanding to live their lives free of persecution. Zan Zindagi Azadim. In October, I joined the Freedom Human Chain event that took place in cities around the world. It was a powerful expression of global support for the women of Iran whose bravery started this movement, but that is also inspired and strengthened by the grief and the continued voices and actions for the past 3 years that this community and you families have been pushing. Notre gouvernement a imposé certaines des sanctions les plus sévères au monde contre le régime iranien et ses hauts dirigeants. On a interdit des dizaines de milliers de hauts responsables d'entrer au Canada. We have permanently and forever banned leaders from Iran from ever being able to take safe haven in Canada, and we will continue to stand and look for even more to do to ensure that this brutal, murderous regime is held fully to account. Many of you came here to Canada to build a better life, in a place where justice and peace are a way of life. That's what Canada is, and that's what our government will continue to stand up for, and that's what the people of Iran deserve in their own country. After this memorial, many of us will go to a vigil across the street. Vigils are being held tonight across Canada, in Vancouver, Nanaimo, Calgary, Edmonton, Regina, Saskatoon, Winnipeg, Ottawa, London, Sudbury, Montreal, and St. John's. The entire Canadian family shares in your sadness. Your courage and your resilience continue to inspire us all, and on this day and every day, we continue to be here with you. We continue to be here for you. Merci. Zan Zindagi Azadine.